Welcome back to Anatomy Classes. This is Dr. Rajita. Today we shall learn about chromosomes and karyotyping. Chromosomes are genetical materials which are present inside the nucleus. And chromosomes are made up of genes. And study of morphology of chromosomes is known as cytogenetics. And during interphase of a normal human cell is regarded as a eukaryotic cell, because it consists of nucleus covered by a nuclear membrane, and chromosomes are enveloped by this nuclear membrane. And these chromosomes appears to be highly coiled and elongated during resting phase of a cell, which is called as interphase. So during resting phase, that is during interphase of a cell, the chromosomes appears to be highly coiled, elongated structures which are called as heterochromatin. Heterochromatin is highly coiled and clumped and darker zone. And euchromatin is that part of chromosomes which appears to be pale, light in color. So this is a normal human cell showing a nucleus and the cell organelles present in the cytoplasm and further surrounded by cytoplasmic membrane. Let's see about the cell cycle. The cell cycle, it has got several phases. So if the cell wants to be in a resting phase, it will be in a phase called G1 phase, which is a gap phase. During gap phase, the cell will be in a resting. Suppose the cell wants to divide, it has to divide to form a new cell, so it will enter a phase called as S phase or synthesis phase. In our body, most of the cells are present in this gap phase, where it is an exit GO phase. And synthesis phase lasts for around 7 hours, where they prepare the cell for division. And synthesis phase enters into the gap 2 phase, which lasts for around half an hour to 1 hour. Further, the gap 2 phase enters to form a cell division phase, where it enters into mitosis. And so divisions are of two types, mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis are often happens in the somatic cells, and meiosis is seen in during gametogenesis, that is during spermatogenesis in males and oogenesis in females. And this is the mitosis which happens in the somatic cells, and mitosis is further divided into prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. These are the four phases of mitosis. And metaphase is the phase where the chromosomes are highly condensed and clear to understand. So let's see the chromosomes in metaphase. Chromosome. The literal meaning of a chromosome is chroma means color, soma means body. So first time when they were discovered under the microscope, they appeared to be like colored bodies, which are rod-like appearance. And chromosomes in metaphase, they are highly condensed and they consist of units of heredity called as genes. And these genes are located over the chromosome in a particular position, which is called as loci. And the number of chromosomes are fixed to a particular kind of organism. In humans, the number of chromosomes are 46 chromosomes, means 23 pairs of chromosomes. Out of these 23 pairs, 22 pairs of chromosomes or 44 chromosomes are called as autosomes, and one pair or two chromosomes are called as allosomes or sex chromosomes. So to write the chromosomal complement, for a male we write 46, that is the number of chromosomes, and sex chromosomes are X and Y. In female, the chromosomal complement is written as 46 and XX, which represents the sex chromosomes or allosomes. So that is how we write the complement, genet of chromosomal complement. And if you see the parts of a chromosome when they are highly condensed, the two rod-like structures are called as chromatids, and these chromatids are constricted a part where it is paler in appearance under microscope, called as centromeres. And upper chromatids are short, they are called as short arm or P arm. And the lower chromatids are longer and they are called as Q arm. The tips of the chromatids is called as telomere. And based upon the position of the centromere, there are three types of chromosomes which we see normally in human chromosomes. The three types are metacentric chromosome, where the centromere is present in the middle of the chromosome. Submetacentric chromosome, the centromere is away from the middle. It is somewhere in the midpoint between the middle and the telomere or the tip of the chromatid, that is called as submetacentric chromosome. In acrocentric chromosome, the centromere is present to one end, having a very short P arm, and which are connected to a coiled structure called as satellites. And the Q arm is the quite longer end, acrocentric chromosome. There is one more variety of chromosomes which are called as telocentric, where they consist of only long arms, that is, those are Q arms, no P arms are present in telocentric, and telocentric chromosomes are not seen in humans. So these are the varieties of chromosomes, and let's understand what is karyotyping and what is the procedure of karyotyping and how to classify the chromosomes and obtain the karyogram or ideogram of a person. What is karyotyping? Karyotyping is the process of obtaining chromosomes during metaphase of cell division. The metaphasic spread which is obtained is analyzed and photographed, which is called as a karyogram or ideogram. And each organism has got its own number of chromosomes present in each individual cell of the organism. So these are the organisms which are often used for genetical studies, like Drosophila having 8 chromosomes, honeybee 32, goldfish 94, rat is having 42 and rabbit 48, cat 38, dog 78, gorilla and chimpanzees are having 48, and we humans are having 46 number of chromosomes. So out of 46 chromosomes, 44 are autosomes and 2 are sex chromosomes, which are called as allosomes. So why we need to do this karyotyping? It is a very important clinical diagnostic tool which is helpful to understand the chromosomal aberrations and numerical anomalies present in the chromosomes. So how to begin with, how to do karyotyping? Here is the flowchart to understand the basic steps in karyotyping. That is, first we have to put for the culture, that is called inoculation. After inoculation, we have to incubate the culture for 2 to 3 days. Normally it is done for 3 days for 72 hours. Then we have to add a chemical to stop the cells at metaphase stage. The inoculation has to be transferred to a centrifuge tube, and after several centrifugations we have to add fixative, and after several washes with the fixative we have to mount over the slide. So the cells are spreaded over the slide to see the metaphasic spread of chromosomes, and further they are stained to see under the microscope. And after seeing, we analyze to prepare a ideogram or karyogram. So this is the basic idea about the karyotype procedure. The collection of blood. Usually for karyotyping, peripheral blood is taken. Around 2 to 3 ml of peripheral blood is taken. Apart from peripheral blood, we can use bone marrow, we can use the buccal cell typing. So approximately around 2 to 3 ml of blood is taken in a heparin coated vacutainer. Heparin is an anticoagulant which prevents the blood to coagulate. And the karyotyping is always done in a fresh blood. So once we collect the blood, the karyotyping should be initiated within 24 hours. So before beginning with the culture, preparation of culture medium and inoculation of blood into the culture medium, we have to maintain the sterile precautions. Sterility is very important. So the aseptic precautions are maintained by cleaning the stage where we are going to perform the inoculation. So these are the culture materials. Usually the culture materials are stored in refrigerators, and these culture materials has to come down to normal temperature, so they are kept out under aseptic precautions for around half an hour to reach the normal temperature. So the common culture materials which are used are the RPMI, the important culture medium that is called Rosenwell Park Memorial Institute, which is the institute prepared this RPMI, and the RPMI 1640 is used for lymphocyte culture of peripheral blood. So around 5 ml of RPMI is taken to a test tube. Then we have to add it to the same test tube PHA. PHA is 5-hemoagglutinin. 5-hemoagglutinin is extracted from red kidney beans or French beans. They around 150 microliters of 5-hemoagglutinin is added to the culture tube. Why we are adding PHA? It is actually to increase the cell division. It is a mitogenic agent which increases the mitosis. Next, some antibiotics are added to prevent the bacterial growth. Commonly used antibiotics here, we are using gentamicin, penicillin, streptomycin can also be used to prevent the bacterial growth. Around 150 ml of gentamicin is added to the test tube. For the nourishment of the cell growth, we need serum. Commonly used serum are fetal bovine serum or fetal calf serum. Around 1.5 ml of fetal bovine or fetal calf serum is added to the culture tubes. So this is a culture tube containing all the culture materials. Now we are going to inoculate with the blood. So around 6 to 10 drops of whole blood can be added to the culture tubes, or else we can centrifuge the blood which we collect and try to take the buffy coat, that is a WBCs, alone and put into the culture tube. In this way we can get more number of lymphocytes and so more number of spreads. So the whole blood is added. After adding the whole blood, we have to seal the culture tube properly and label it so that there won't be any misinterpretation, and incubate it. Incubation is done for 72 hours at 37 degrees centigrade, that is normal human body temperature. So the chemical which is added is the colchicine, which is added at the end of 70th hour, that is 2 hours before the end of incubation, and that is before harvesting. The colchicine arrests the mitosis at metaphase by preventing the formation of spindle tubules. So after adding the colchicine, we are going to incubate again for 1 hour. So at the 71st hour, we are going to take the culture tubes and centrifuge it at 1000 RPM and for 10 minutes. All through the procedure of karyotype, the centrifugation is done at same rate at 1000 RPM for about 10 minutes. So after doing centrifugation, the supernatant is removed and KCL is hypotonic treatment with KCL solution. So after removing the supernatant, we are going to add around 6 to 10 ml of KCL over a vertex mixture. This is a vertex mixture over which we are going to add KCL slowly along the walls of the test tube. This is done actually to make the cells swell up. So the swollen cells are more fragile, and when they are fallen from a height, the nucleus spreads very clearly, showing the metaphase. It is just like an egg falling from a height, and the shell breaks out. After doing the hypotonic treatment, again we have to keep the culture tube back into the incubator for around half an hour. Now we are going to complete all 72 hours. So at the end of 72 hours, now we are going to harvest the cells. So harvesting is done by adding a fixative. The fixatives used are methanol and glacial acetic acid in the ratio of 3:1. So methanol is 3 times and glacial acetic acid is 1 part. So we are going to mix them and add slowly drop by drop along the walls of the test tube over the vertex mixture. So after adding fixative, we can see the culture medium gets changed in its color. And after several washes with the fixative, it is like around 2 to 3 washes should be done so that the base of the test tube should have a white pellet and the rest of the fluid should be transparent watery fluid. So till we get a white pellet, we should keep on washing with the fixative. So if fixative is added, then again centrifuged, then again remove the supernatant, again add the fixative, again centrifuge it, again remove the supernatant. So once we get the white pellet, we can remove all the supernatant, keeping the white pellet with 2 to 3 ml of fixative. So this can be stored as long as we want. Next, preparation of the slide. To prepare the slide, first we have to clean the slides and keep the slides in the chilled methanol. So such slides should be made chill, and by keeping them in the refrigerator, immersing in the methanol solution. Dropping of the pellet is very, very important. The pellet has to be dropped more than 2 feet height, around 2 feet height over a glass slide, and glass slide should be held at the angle of 40 degrees, and with the use of a pipette we can drop the white pellet along with the fixative over a chilled slide. So now the slide is made. After air drying the slide, we have to stain the slide. So the common staining which is done to see bands are GTG banding, and prior to GTG banding, to confirm the chromosomes whether they are present in the slide or not, we can do simple GIMSA stain. Simple GIMSA staining is just adding the GIMSA solution, the stain, directly over the slide and keep it over for around 8 minutes and then wash off the slide and see under the microscope. But in this procedure, we cannot appreciate the banding pattern over the chromosomes, but we can see the chromosomes and we can identify the numerical anomalies in the chromosomes. We can see in banding, this is a chromosomal spread after GIMSA banding. This is how the based upon the position of the centromere and the length of the chromosome, we are classifying into A, B, C, D, E, F, G groups. A group contains first 3 pairs of chromosomes. B is having 4th and 5th pair. C is the largest group, where it has got 6 to 12 pairs of chromosomes. And D has got 13, 14, 15 pairs. And E is having 16 and 18 pairs. And 19, 20 falls under F group. And G group consists of acrocentric chromosomes with 21, 22 pairs. And X chromosome can be considered under C group. And Y chromosome can be considered as in the G group as acrocentric chromosome. So these are the chromosomes which are classified. This is a normal banding pattern. So normal GTG banding, these are the normal banding pattern which acts like a reference for identifying the chromosomes and arranging them in pairs. So this is the karyogram or the ideogram which is obtained after pairing the chromosomes based upon the banding pattern. And here is the normal male karyogram showing X and Y. So these banding patterns are very important. Based upon International System for Human Cytogenetic Nomenclature, each area of chromosome is given number. The numbering is done in such a way that the area which is near the centromere are numbered the least, like 1, 2, 3 we can see, and the area which is away from the centromere are the highest numbers. There are other procedures of karyotyping. Modern way is called as spectral karyotyping, where the chromosomes are painted using different probes, and designing probes are very important in spectral karyotyping. And identifying certain chromosomes with the markers, it is commonly used in cancer cytogenetics. For example, leukemia having Philadelphia chromosome, which can be used with the help of a marker. And there are other way of staining like NOR banding, R banding, which is a reversal banding, C banding, which is specific to centromeric, Q banding, where quinacrine mustard stain is used for Q banding, and it is observed under fluorescent microscope. So these are the varieties of other banding which can be used in karyotyping. I hope you all like my session. Like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell button for further notification. Bye.